The 63 Impala by AMT is up next. This is a 4-in-1 kit. Stock, drag, custom, and advanced custom for those who really like to hack into styrene. Let's take a look inside this box. And mentioning the box, it is really heavy with all the extra parts. When you pick up a box like that, don't you love that? You pick that up and that thing's got some heft to it. You can't hear anything moving in there because it's packed in there so tight. We've got the one-piece chassis here with exhaust molded in. Fuel tank, we got our front suspension in, and the top of the fenders even have some wiring put in them, so that's pretty cool. We've got our nice Impala SS interior with a molded in back seat, center console, and door panels. We'll need to attach, of course, our dashboard and front seats. We've got that nice Impala body. There is a little bit of flash on there. You're going to want to sand off some of the sharper edges on the corners, a swipe with a hobby knife, and you are all done. Beautiful strong molding. We'll be able to do the trim work around there without any problems. It's got good molding around the roof line and everything, so that will all be able to be worked on. Even the windshield wipers are prominent, so you'll be able to do anything you need to do with those. That is a nice big long Impala body. Of course, we've got our clear parts tree, and this one it is a one-piece windshield and back glass with some custom red parts in there and our headlights behind there. We'll get to see all that later. Just don't want to scratch it. We're going to get some random stuff out here. Some loose parts, some full parts. We've got two types of seats. Just that flash is so thin, it just comes off real easy. Don't worry about it. You have the option of doing this kit as a curbside if you want. So that's the bottom of your engine and transmission. And you'll see that we do have the full option of building the engine and transmission. Check out that advanced custom hood on this thing. It's even got detail on the bottom. That would be a funky, funky ride. We've got a convertible boot top if you feel like doing some surgery and making this thing a drop top. We've got our steering wheel. We've got our nice dashboard there. Beautiful. We've got our firewall. We've got battery horns. Radiator, that custom hood I think was on there. Since it was off, let's put some more stuff up here. We got custom parts, we got stock parts intermingled on the trees. We've got a television and a back for it. We've got a trophy, we got a bunny rabbit, we got a roll cage wrapped in padding. We've got some pipe dumps. We've got some very scoops on there. We've got a record player and cover. We've got seat belts that are separate, which is awesome. Makes them easy to paint. And we've got a harness there. On this one, we got that 409 with the intake, belts and pulley system, manifolds, cylinder heads. We got some custom parts here. Check that out. That big dip in there. We got all kinds of stuff in here that you'll be able to save for those that like to hoard their parts. Of course, we got our stock hood here. You can build it beautifully stock. More custom parts and accessories, body moldings, all kinds of stuff in there that make that all full of styrene. Two entire chrome trees, stock grills, custom grills, two sets of wheels. We got knockoffs if you want to use them. We've got buckets and lights and trim, stock hubcaps, stock grill and bumper. I like those mags there. Those are pretty cool looking. I'm probably going to have to use those. We've got more custom parts here, including tools, grills, screens, dress-up parts, all kinds of fancy schmancy pantsy stuff. We've got one set of tires, pad printed with a white wall on one side and the Firestone logos on the other. Beautiful tread pattern, one set of tires in this bad boy, and then the decal sheet, beautifully designed. We've got TV screens on there, we've got dash decals, we've got number placards, we've got stripes for the top sides, checkered flags, sponsorships, names for the car, license plates, all kinds of awesome stuff on there. And last but not least, we've got that nice metal axle. So I'm going to rinse the parts off in some simple green to remove any oils on the plastic, and then I will begin building. Now before you start cutting parts off and gluing, you're going to want to make your decision on how you want to build it out of the four ways. Now I'm going to be using a mix and mash of different parts because the way I have chosen to build it, because of the cool decals that are in the kit and everything, I'm going to build one of those cars that you can go to a car show or go to an auto parts store and see it parked out front. It's like a replica local stock car. In other words, everything underneath it is pretty much a general Impala. But they'll have cool graphics on the doors. They'll have the souped up engine. They'll have the roll cage in it. They'll have the racing harness in the seat. Stuff like that. They'll have the little fire extinguisher inside. All because they want it to look like it is a stock car, but it's completely streetable. So they'll have the real exhaust on it and everything. And it's something that they can drive around town. And it looks cool everywhere it's parked. And it looks great at car shows. I love seeing those in person. And now with this kit being very easy to do with that because of the decals that are in the box, that's exactly what I'm going to be doing with this one. So that's my idea. The interior doesn't need any work except if you want to use the roll cage. Go ahead, glue that together. Sit it in place, you know exactly where it's going to be. I definitely want to have that in there. That looks awesome. I'm going to use the stock front seats, but what I'm going to do with those front seats is I'm going to be putting this harness on after I paint it, and of course I'll be using both of the stock seat belts because he still drives it every single day. So it's not, you know, he's got to have it safe and use the factory parts. The engine goes together well. It is a simplistic 409. Those are valve covers, not cylinder heads when I started putting it together. We're going to paint that up, according to the box, a Chevy orange. There really is no carburation, just that tall post. And then our stock air cleaner will go over the top. And that'll look lovely on there underneath the hood. If you decide to just build it as a curbside, you will be gluing your hood in place and attaching that larger plate that I showed. On here also, I've got the belt and pulley system all together. It's just one thing. We're going to paint it black. I'll highlight that generator or alternator silver, and we're all set. Even though I won't be really using it, I had to put the TV together, and I'm going to be detailing that and using that decal because it's a model TV, and I've never built one before, and that's awesome. Same as the little trophy. That's really cool. That just glues to its base. And let it sit, and you're all set, ready to go. The fire extinguisher, I just scraped some of the seams off. We'll be putting that inside on the console per the illustrations and the manual to get that set. I'm going to be using these wheels on mine. If you're going to be using those wheels, what you want to do is you want to glue the pegs into the chassis. You don't have to glue them in, but I am gluing them in. Then you'll want to make sure you'll probably have to take a drill bit or your X-Acto knife and clean out those holes because of the chrome on the pegs and the chrome on the wheels. Just make sure that they fit on correctly and you won't have any problems. You'll want to do the same with that rear metal axle and the rear wheels to make sure you're not at the end of the build trying to slam things and press them in. The dashboard is going to be done completely stock. We're going to paint it up, put our decals on it, and that's going to be that. I am using the custom steering wheel. I like this steering wheel more. It's more of a sporty one, and a replica race car would have a much more simpler steering wheel than the factory one, in my opinion. The manifolds press in so nice into the sides of the engine. They just shove right in and hold. So the engine's like a press fit model, pretty much. Those go in so nice that I'm going to be able to paint those separately. I can just grab onto the peg here, give them their little rusty metal color, and those are ready to go. We've got our radiator, battery, horn, and master cylinder. Those are all going to need to be painted up and detailed and attached later. On the body itself, I did glue in the firewall. You can easily do so. You'll see that they want you to do it later. I want to get it painted with the body. I've seen some Impalas with a body-colored firewall and front mount. I've seen some with a black one. We're going to do this all body color. This car has been worked on so many times. It's not a perfect restoration car. But see, you can still get your interior in around that firewall, even though the manual says to put it in at just as the same time. So we know that that lines up, and I was able to double-check that. And then I was able to press-fit the chassis on there using those nice large pegs and get that in there. Everything lines up beautifully, so do your test fitting right away. And we've got our stock hood, so I'm gonna get this all into paint. We're gonna get to see what colors I've picked for this beautiful Impala SS. We'll get everything primed, of course, first. We'll do that chassis all in a black. I'll be able to hand pick out that exhaust all the way back. We got our differential, it's all one piece. We're not going to be spending a lot of time underneath, but I will do a light weathering on it after I get the exhaust painted, just so we know that it's definitely a used Impala and it's not a factory perfect SS restoration, which aren't really my thing ever. We're going to get in, we're going to get some paint, we're going to pick out my interior color, we're going to get it all worked up, and when we go over to the booth, Fresh from the fumes, the engine is still drying. I've got the masking on there and I painted the transmission a quick silver, so that looks nice underneath there. I can't wait to hand paint the television. Now you can really see the detail on there. That thing is cool. I don't see the bottom, so I don't worry about it. I'm going to do a silver tone trim and knobs black wash in there. I'm going to use one of the cool decals they provided, and then I'm going to do a wood tone around the sides and a flat tan on the back like they always did on those TVs. The trophy is chromed up. We're going to leave that alone, aside from a black wash and the flags to bring out a little bit of variation on those. What I'm going to be doing for the interior, I want a black interior on this one, and I'm going to be using, I got a hold of a bunch of these bottles super cheap on clearance for less than a buck. It's regular tester's gloss coat. You can airbrush it as is, it's super thin, or you can brush it on. So I'm going to be brushing it on the seats, I'm going to be brushing it on the front seats, and the dashboard and the door panels to give detail. When that dries, then I will go in and silver tone the bottom of the dash. I will apply our dash decals, and that's pretty much done. I looked up a picture of a black SS, and I thought the glove box might be silver or something, but nope. It's all black gloss with just a little bit of metallic trim, and then the gauges all the way in the center. So a lot of this is going to be pretty easy. Same with the seats. The seat posts on the back are chrome, so I will be doing those with a silver marker. And then just the little buttons in the seats are silver. Same with the back seats. We got little silver buttons, and then there is a decal that goes in the center for the silver there. And then the door panels are the same way, just a little bit of chrome accents that I'll be able to put in with a silver gel pen, and we're all set. The roll cage is done. I will just dry brush that a little bit, touch up the black, the flat black where I held it to paint it, and then I will dry brush that to bring out some detail with a lighter shade of gray or something. We'll get that all worked on. The radiator, battery, and horns are done, aside from a little bit of silver detail on all of those. The over-the-shoulder lap belt, the over-the-shoulder lap belts, the over-the-shoulder belts for the driver's seat for a replica racer just need some silver buckle adornment and a quick wash to bring out the detail in there. The manifolds are all painted up in their rust color. They look cool like that. They're going to look nice on the side of the engine. Our fire extinguisher is red. That goes right on the console. On that console, before I forget, this needs to be silver, and this upper area needs to be silver, so we'll handle all that. The air cleaner on the 409 that I looked at online was chrome, so that looks sharp to me. And then we've got the seat belts, which will just be chrome detailed on the buckles, and then those will be glued into place as black over the gloss black seats. On the grill, what I'm going to do is burnish that in with some black and then gently rub it out with Q-tips, not getting any in the headlights. Then I will do the headlights themselves, the glass area, in a Molotow chrome, so that that brings out the shine on those and they don't look exactly in there. The body is all done in that spa blue. Pretty much all I have to do with the body is do my trim work around the windows, around the top, along the long side there. Decals will be taking care of our emblems for us. The 409, I'll have to paint in the turn signal, the reflectors, but that's okay. Do my windshield wipers, get all those set, and pretty much the body is ready to go. I see on some of the SS's, the taillight area is a silver or metallic color. Some it's body color. I haven't decided what I'm going to do with mine yet, but we'll get to that point. The hood doesn't need any work at all except for a decal towards the end. The chassis here, I'm going to highlight the exhaust by hand brushing it. Then I'm just going to give a dry brush to the chassis so that it looks like a used car. But other than that, we're not going to worry about that at all. So, as usual, I will start working on things when I've got the interior buttoned up, we've got the engine finished off, and towards the chassis, we will come back for another look. Super easy build up to this point. I've been using some craft paints to not only paint the exhaust, but also give it a nice little weathering on there so that it comes out nice and patinaed looking, and it doesn't look like it's completely rotted out, but I love that little bit of driven around for half a decade look at least. So I like that look on there. We got the dashboard done. Boy, that gloss coat really works nice over flat black to give you that vinoplastic look that I love. Then I painted inside the dashboard here, highlighted with some black marker, added the radio decal, and added the dash gauge decal on there, and we are all done with that beauty. The paint I used inside the dashboard is just some nice tester silver. That worked out just fine. On the wheel and tire package, that looks cool. I painted inside on the spokes on those wheels and left the rest chrome. Then I took the wheel back and I marked it black with a black marker so that we'd have a black shadow behind there. Then I stuck both halves together with my fix-it-all adhesive. It's just a silicone adhesive that you get at the dollar store, made by the same people that make the super glue that I use, that I love to use to stick things together. So that holds those together without getting any cloudiness on my tires, and I gave them a pretty good sanding. They're pretty used. This guy, he's got the 409. He's burning his tires off all the time to show off with his fake stock car. So I've got the rear bumper done. I just did the side moldings in a little bit of silver because I like how it looked on the back of the box like that. And then I'm going to do the taillights the exact same way on my kit. We'll look at those in a second. The grill is all set and done. We got that nice black in there. We have the yellow turn signals. I blacked out even the front sections, and then I'll have to put my license plate in there. But that looks lovely on there. And then I use the Molotow on the headlights to make it look like it wasn't chrome plastic, but give it more of a glass look. To wash inside that grill there, whoa, it just keeps falling down. I use the Tamiya Panaline accent color, works well. No issues at all ever with that. We've got the 409 ready to be dropped into that chassis. It is a nice looking model. I saw a lot of ones online had the silver valve covers, and that's totally cool. The instructions called for orange. I already had them painted orange. So the kid decided to give it a little accent on the raised detail, and I really like that. So he did that on his own. We got the rusted manifolds on there. Those look great in that rust-colored Rust-Oleum paint. And we're all set. All that needs is the air cleaner pushed down on top, and we're ready to bolt that in. Looks like a used but not abused 409. The roll cage is all set. Did some dry brushing with that to bring out with a dark gray, to bring out some of the detail. That will fit in our interior. Let me just drop it in. That fits in like that when we're all ready to go. And that gives us a nice look inside with that padded foam. The interior itself, what a beauty. You wouldn't expect that. You'd say, oh, well, it looks like an old promo model. How much detail can you get? Well, use that gloss coat over the flat black. We get excellent contrast. I got the belts kind of sitting cattywampus in there like you just got out of the car. We got the other seat belts in there. That all looks awesome. We got our little fire extinguisher on the center console. We got our shifter in place. We got the center console silvered out. We got the center medallion in the back seat. And then I went and did a silver paint pen on all the little dots and buttons inside the interior. And that's going to look absolutely fantastic when we're all done. Pushed up inside, that will be lovely in there. We've got all the trim on the body done. That really doesn't need much of a look-see yet. No glass in it, just the silver trim done. And I hand-painted the back, the taillight bezel, with the exact same tester silver that I've been using. That's not going to be a problem at all. What I will do is take my clear red and go around and get it in there, and then the rest is all decal work. We'll be perfectly fine. So, yeah, we've got everything going together well. You can see the cool little trophy. Did a little black wash on those flags, left the rest chrome. And the accessory de resistance. I am waiting for the decal solvent to work on that large decal. But we've got the television on. It's a cool little display. I really like it. I hand painted it. What I did was I used that Kraft milk chocolate paint, lightly brushed over the black to give me that faux wood look on the sides. Kind of rough looking, but that's going to be for the TV repair shop who sponsors this car. So I definitely wanted that. Plus, I've never built a television, a little 1/25th scale mini television. So that looks awesome, and that will display beautifully with the car. All I need to do after this is put my axle in, put my wheels on. I will put the glass in the body, push the interior in. That just goes underneath. Huge locating pins underneath for everything. Everything just pushes in. There really is no having to slide or anything in funny. Underneath the hood, got the radiator. This is actually a friction fit. I just shoved it in there, and I've got the horns glued in there, so that looks cool. The body needs clear coating, but we're going to get the decals on first. I'm going to be using the number plates and the sponsor decals, but none of the drag style decals, just a couple maybe sponsor logos or the checkered flags. I really like those. So this is everything very easy to put together so far. No fit issues. We will come back for that final if there is any issue getting the chassis inside the body or lining the interior up. I will let you know. I'm not anticipating anything, but when we come back, we'll find out. Another awesome kit from the folks at AMT in 1/25th scale, the 63 Chevy Impala hardtop, the SS version with the 409 under the hood is all done. And another easy build kit with great detail, gives you a lovely looking model car. I treated this with Future floor polish, 2 coats of it after I was done, and she looks lovely. She looks like a pretty factory gloss. They weren't super shiny back then, and this one looks great. I love the replica stock car racer look that I did to it. It is awesome. They grab great details. Check out that little television with the little display. The chrome trophy, don't forget the record player, the bunny rabbit, the custom accessories. There's so much stuff in that box. And even after applying all those big decals on the kit, you still have all these other decals left over. Massive amounts of detailing, which will work on any other car kit you have, depending on how you choose to go with this, whether it's one of the four things, you know, advanced customizing, customized, drag, stock, whatever you want. I love my version with the black walls, like he's just driving it around, having a good time, making it look like a replica stock car from 63, and he really enjoys his car, and so did I. Zero fit issues. The bumpers just push on with a friction fit. The entire chassis with those four large posts push in with a friction fit. The interior, where I showed you those posts are, just little dabs of super glue will hold it in place perfectly. Same with the windshield, just little dabs on the back of super glue, and that holds in. The interior pushes up, holds the glass in, and you don't have any problems. You can see that awesome roll cage, the driver's seat belt in there, the fire extinguisher, and that nice black on black interior is a good fit for that baby blue, that spa blue. I like how the grill comes out with just a light wash on there. We got the Pennsylvania, the older style license plates, and you can detail those wheels however you wish, or throw the stock hubcaps on there or other wheels as you choose. No problems at all. It's a nice straight body, no warpage. It sits on all four tires. I want to thank the peeps at Round 2 for sending this over. My guys over there, thanks a million. What an awesome kit. As always, build for you. Have fun. Let the haters be your motivators. Always smile when you're building your kits, because this is the best hobby on the planet. And we will see you at the next review.